So, sorry there for a little interruption. This is live on TV, so things might go a little bit wrong. But anyway, like we were saying, John is here just before we get to, we're privileged enough to hear your amazing orchestra at work. And what's it been like? What's it like now coming to the last few hours of an amazing journey?
I've been so busy actually writing the music for the season. I haven't really had time to think about it. I mean, a couple of days ago, I wrote the final cue, and that felt very strange.
Mm.
Thinking, you know, I'm never going to write or use that material again. So it's such a different thing doing such a long running TV series to a film, because you're really kind of concentrated over a period of 6 years. You know, and I've had that ability to kind of mould that material, and and the material is kind of sort of growing with me. And the fact that I'm never going to kind of really sort of use it again is going to be really weird.
Do you get then a fondness for certain characters, like, because with each character, with Maggie and with Michelle and Dan, their relationship, there's like motifs that keep on coming back. Do you have a fondness for certain characters?
I mean, I've always said that the motifs are not really about the individual characters; they're actually more about the relationships between those people.
Okay.
I mean, except the house has kind of got its own sort of character. You know that. I mean, in many ways, the actual theme tune is really kind of about the house, because the house, you know, kind of is about everybody in it. You know, the drama is kind of about everybody that's in Downton Abbey, and it kind of encapsulates all that.
So what came first then, when you were sitting down at the piano, like the very early thoughts of this show, like how does it work, like when you start off composing? Do you just sit down with loads of ideas about what you want to say, or and then it just kind of comes out?
It's kind of, you know, I always work to the picture, and you know, the music's one of the last things that goes on, so the picture's sort of finally edited. And you know, and the music's very much about the timing, you know, and it's about taking you, you know, through from one scene through to the other, and kind of it helps to make the drama quite, you know, feel like one thing, even though in Downton, you know, there's a lot of cutting, you know, it's quite fast paced Downton, but funnily enough, it doesn't, you know, sort of feel overly paced, and you know, and I think the music sort of helps that. It helps to glue things together. So I just improvise.
Really?
You know, yeah, to the picture, yeah.
Yeah, and did you know when you had the sort of key theme in its basic form on the piano, did you know that then...
Yeah, I mean, the title was... We didn't have a title in series one. It was in the first episode. It only kicked in episode two. And it started off with a train, so, you know, I kind of had this... You know, train, and then there was a bass, you know, leaning out the window, and I picked out this kind of, you know, sort of lone tune, which kind of signified bass.
Right.
And then it cut to the clouds, which were following the telegram.
Yeah.
And this telegram was carrying the news that the heir to Downton Abbey had been killed or drowned in the Titanic. So I had this kind of string theme that went. Kind of more sort of anguished, you know, and then eventually the harmony broadens out when we arrive at a, you know, there's a lovely shot of the house, and it goes, you know, which is kind of slightly more pompous, kind of grand. So, and all those elements actually came, you know, they came out of the pictures.
Yeah.
You know, I'd never have written it if it hadn't been for that very first scene.
That's so amazing that something as iconic as that and as stirring, if it was just slightly different in any way from the pictures, it might have been a completely different song.
Yeah.
So from that, and you take it to a huge orchestra like this, what are the big complications that you, like day to day, in kind of making this huge orchestral sound?
Well, we've had quite a lot of experience. I've done quite a lot of it before, and I've got a really good team of people working for me. You know, I've got a really good sound engineer, Paul Golding, who kind of takes care of all that. Somebody who does the conducting and the orchestration. And so, you know, a lot of the kind of day-to-day running has just been taken off my hands. I really kind of concentrate purely on writing it.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I spend, there's a lot of to-ing, fro-ing between myself and Gareth Neame, you know, about between the two of us. And Liz Truebridge, the producer, has also been incredibly supportive. But Gareth and I kind of really do the music between the two of us. It's it's very contained, you know, that you know, we discuss it a lot. So that works out quite well. I just really concentrate on writing it.
Yeah, yeah.
And then, you know, and then we come to a fabulous place like this, and, you know, and of course I have to use, you know, computers to write it to begin with. And we have a rough kind of idea of what it will sound like, and it sounds pretty good, but when you actually hear it on real instruments, there is no comparison.
Yes, it's really,
you know, and also you just couldn't, you couldn't do this kind of music just on computer. You just it has to be played live.
Yeah,
you know, I would have had to have written a very different, you know, score. I mean, so I've been very fortunate with, we have a really good music budget, and you know, the producers and the company have recognised that, you know, music's, you know, a big part of it, you know.
Well, it's amazing from my point of view watching just how much goes into supporting the performances, and it just changes the whole mood, the atmosphere completely. It's a real privilege for the actors on it, I think, to be surrounded and supported by all of this.
Yeah, because it must be a bit strange for you, because you just kind of, you know, do your bit on set. You don't even know what's going to get, you know. And then, you know, and then you turn up and
I did have one moment this year when I was like, God, this will be really good when the music gets on it. Like,
oh, I was kind of disappointed.
No, I haven't seen it.
Oh, you haven't seen it yet? Yeah. Right.
But let me just ask you before we go just a couple of questions from Twitter.
Yep.
That's all right. So this is from Nikki Young, who asks, how has the score changed over the six seasons?
I think I've had to, obviously, you know, every episode has some kind of new story strand, you know, I've got to find some elements for. In many ways, it hasn't, you know, I mean, interestingly, we're doing, this is the Christmas special we're recording today, and there are some tunes towards the end that were in episode one of series one.
Really?
Yeah, yeah, and, you know, so a lot of it has kind of actually, you know, has actually stayed.
Yeah.
I think I've found better ways of moving between themes. Yeah.
Yeah. And this from Bex Winch is an interesting question. Do you have any rituals when sitting down to compose?
Two large cups of coffee.
Two large cups of coffee.
A bit of luck.
Do you ever get like a writer's block thing?
Yeah, writer's block's a nightmare. Yeah, no, I do get writer's block, yeah.
Yeah.
But there's nothing like the fear of failure to...
To galvanise you.
Yes.
Okay, this is from Amy Uber Geek, which is an interesting name. What influenced you in composing for Mary and Matthew's theme song?
I don't know what influenced me, but I do remember the music for that is actually one of my favourite scenes. I mean, it's no accident, I think some of the best music also happens with some of the best acting as well, and I think that was a fantastic, I wasn't really thinking of any other kind of music, I just kind of improvised that bit, you know.
Amazing. So you can hear the hustle and bustle of the musicians coming back in. They're just tuning up their instruments, and we're going to soon be joined.
We're going to record the title music now.
We're going to record the title music. So what a privilege. I'll leave you to introduce it, I guess.
Thanks.
Lovely to chat.
Yeah, and you. Great.
Thank you. every single Downton Abbey episode, and of course sitting at the piano is the wonderful composer, John. We've got a treat for you. We're going to do the opening title music for you. There should be six clicks into part one.
Thank you. Thank you.
And again, straight away, please. So John, we still come down at the back end of